This is the TX650M model from Corsair Microsystems, and this is my computer and the motherboard. This is the old power supply which I'm gonna replace. It's enjoy, but I didn't enjoy so much. After I took out the motherboard, I have to take out the back panel in order to access the power supply. Use a Phillips screwdriver. This is my old power supply. I mean, not old, it's not even 2 years old, and my this is freezing because of it, I think. It's a no-name brand, so it's the first I want to replace. And it has a lot of tentacles. And there should be the broken capacitor if this is the problem. The specs for those interested. As you can see, after you took everything out, it would be really nice to take out this snow. This power supply has a very good rating, and that's why I took it, and it has 80 plus gold and 7 years of warranty, and also its connectors. Some zip ties, the manuals, the European type power cable, and the other separate cables, because this power supply is semi-modular, which is a very good thing to do. Here are the two connectors which cannot be taken out from the power supply, because they are essential to every motherboard, because it's the power to the motherboard and to the CPU. This is the 24-pin ATX connector, the 8-pin EPS ATX 12V connector, and 15-pin SATA power. There are three of them, and this is all I need in my case. And it sticks quite good in there, and it doesn't come out easily. That's good. Next step to do is to insert the power supply inside the PC case and try to estimate the best route for the power cables and also SATA cable. After making sure that all of the four screws are tightened up and the power supply is staying straight, you have to find the best route for your cables, just at least estimated. It depends on every PC case. Mine has multiple holes. Next step would be to mount the motherboard inside the PC case. And here's my CPU power connector and the 24-pin ATX cable and the other cables which have to be inserted here. The downside. That looks better than the old cable management I had, but on the other side it doesn't look better at all. I had to work here a bit more. This part won't be visible, so that's why it's a complete chaos here. And the most scary part, it's over, because it was turning on and it's okay, everything. Only this ATX cable, big ugly cable, I had to pass it through here because I didn't have any other option. And the power supply has a little fan inside there, if you see. It's gray. It's noiseless. Now the computer was standing up. And everything looks okay. I mounted the plastic cover. The tensions and the temperatures are looking fine to me. So that's it. Thanks for watching.